Good evening everyone. Welcome to my teacher, especially the students of grade 12, parents and teachers and students. Today I am going to discuss the topic of three-dimensional geometry of class 12. So I hope you are familiar with the topic of vector analysis. We can make the study of vector analysis by making the study of three-dimensional geometry easy. By the system of vector algebra makes us the system of three-dimensional geometry easy and elegant. So first we are moving to the specific objects, that is, in this chapter what are the things we are going to discuss. The first one we are going to discuss about the direction cosines and the direction ratios of a line, and equation of the line and plane in different situations, angle between two lines, angle between two planes, angle between lines and planes, and the shortest distance between the line and the plane. First we can move to the how we can find the direction cosine of a line joining the two points P, x1, y1, z1 and Q, x2, y2, z2. Before that, just we can recall what is a direction cosines and what is a direction ratios. Direction cosines means a directed line which makes an angle alpha, beta and gamma with the x axis, y axis and z axis. Then the cosine of these angles are known as the direction cosines, that is cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are known as the direction cosines of the line. A line which makes an angle alpha, beta and gamma with the x axis, y axis and z axis, then cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are known as the direction cosines of this line. If we reverse the direction of the line, then this angle changes to pi minus alpha. If we change the direction of the line, that is, if we reverse the direction of the line, then the angle alpha changes to pi minus alpha. That is, it becomes cos of pi minus alpha, cos of pi minus beta, and cos of pi minus gamma. Therefore, the direction cosines are minus cos alpha, minus cos beta, and minus cos gamma. Therefore, a line has two direction cosines, cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma, and minus cos alpha, minus cos beta, and minus cos gamma. Then what do you mean by the direction ratios? Any three numbers which are proportional to the direction cosines, any three numbers which are proportional to the direction cosines are known as the direction ratios of the line. The direction ratios are denoted by small letters ABC and the direction cosines are denoted by L, M and N. Then the any three numbers which are proportional to the direction cosine means A is proportional to L, B is proportional to M and C is proportional to n. That is, A equals KL, B equal KM and C equal KN. A equal KL, B equal KM and C equal KN. That is, the direction cosines are cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma. Any three numbers, that is ABC, which are proportional to the direction cosines LMN. Therefore, A proportional to L, B proportional to M and C proportional to N. Therefore, A is equal to KL, B equal KM and C is equal to KN. The first question I asked was, what is the direction cosines of the line joining the points x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2. Here two points are there, Px1, Y1, Z1 and Qx2, Y2, Z2. Therefore, the direction the direction ratios are x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, and z2 minus z1. The direction ratios of the line joining the points x1, y1, z1, and x2, y2, z2 are x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, and z2 minus z1. Or x1 minus x2, y1 minus y2, and z1 minus z2, both are correct. And we already told that the direction ratios are denoted using the letters A, B, and C. That is, A is equal to x2 minus x1, B is equal to y2 minus y1, and C is equal to z2 minus z1. Then from the direction ratios, how we can find the direction cosines? Already the direction ratios we got, x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, and z2 minus z1. Then how we can find the direction cosines are, L is equal to A by root of A square plus B square plus C square. Instead of A, we can substitute the value x2 minus x1 by, instead of A square, x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus 1, that is x2 minus x1 by root of, we can replace this A square by x2 minus x1 the whole square plus, we can replace this B by y2 minus y1 the whole square and plus c square by z2 minus z1 the whole square. The direction cosines, L is equal to A by root of A square plus B square plus C square is equal to x2 minus x1 by root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus z1 the whole square. The same way, what is the value of M? M is equal to B by root of A square plus B square plus C square. Therefore, we can replace B by y2 minus y1 by A square by the same equation, same denominator, we can write it here. That is x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus z1 the whole square. And the last one, that is N is equal to C by root of A square plus B square plus C square. Therefore, instead of C, we can substitute the value z2 minus z1 by the denominator is same like L and M. Therefore, from the direction ratios, how to find the direction cosines is, if the direction ratios are A, B, C of a line, then direction cosines are L, M, N. From the direction ratios, how to find the direction cosines is, L is equal to A by root of A square plus B square plus C square is equal to x2 by x2 minus x1 by root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus z1 the square. And m equal b by root of a square plus b square plus c square. Therefore, y2 minus y1 by the denominator is same like as L. And n is equal to c by root of a square plus b square plus c square. Therefore, z2 minus z1 by the denominator is same as that. Then, what is the relation between the direction cosines and direction ratios? Can be asked for a one more question for the board exam. What is the relation between the direction cosines and direction ratios of a line means, L equal A by root of A square plus B square plus C square, and B by, M equal B by, and N equal C by root of the same thing will come. Then, today's our objective of the lesson is to find the equation of a line according to the different situations in 3D space. Equation of line in different situations in 3D. For that, first one is equation of a line which passing through a fixed point and parallel to a given vector. two conditions are there given here. Passing through a point. The conditions are very important. Passing through a point and parallel to a given vector. Parallel to a given vector. If these two conditions are given, then how we can find the equation of a line? The passing through a point with the position vector vector A and parallel to a vector with position vector vector M. Two conditions are here. Passing through a point with vector A, with the position vector is vector A, and parallel to another vector, one vector they will give with the position vector vector M. Then the equation of the line is vector R equal, this vector R is a general vector, vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda M. Here vector A is a passing through the point with position vector A, and M is a given vector, that is parallel vector given in the question. Lambda is a scalar or is a constant. Then the first one is equation of the line passing through a point and parallel to a given vector is vector R equal vector A plus lambda M. A is a passing through the point and M is a parallel vector. In this chapter, we will derive the equations in vector form. After that, we can convert the vector equations into Cartesian form. Therefore, for the exam, you can use vector or Cartesian form, that we will study later how we can convert it through. Therefore, no need to study the both the equations, but if you study one equation, we can convert vector to Cartesian and Cartesian to vector form. Here, all things are in vectors instead except lambda. Therefore, this equation is in vector form. Therefore, the vector equation of a line passing through a point with position vector vector A and parallel to a vector vector M is vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda M. This is a vector equation of a line according to the given condition. This we can see it on the screen. Therefore, let A be the position vector of the point and vector M is a parallel vector. Parallel vector. Then the equation is vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda M. Then the next one is how we can convert this equation into Cartesian form. The given equation is vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda M. This is a vector form. How we can convert this vector equation into Cartesian form? We know that vector R is a general vector. Therefore, the general vector we can denote it by vector R is equal to xi plus yj plus zk. And passing through the point with position vector vector A is x1i plus y1j plus z1k. That is vector R is equal to xi plus yj plus zk. Vector A is equal to x1i plus y1j plus z1k. And the other condition is parallel to a given vector, that is vector M, is equal to ai plus bj plus ck. Here A, B, C are the direction ratios of the given line. Vector M is equal to ai plus bj plus ck, where A, B, C are the direction ratios of the given line is given. Then, what is the Cartesian form of the equation? According to vector R is equal to A plus lambda M. That is, instead of vector A, we can substitute xi plus yj plus zk is equal to vector A will replace by x1i plus y1j plus z1k plus lambda into ai plus bj plus ck. Then, from here, we can equate the components of I. What is the component of I? Here it is x. And from here, we know that the components of I is x1 plus lambda A. First, we equate the component of I, then x is equal to x1 plus lambda a. Therefore, x minus x1 is equal to lambda a, x minus x1 by a is equal to lambda. Similarly, if we equate the j components, we will get y minus y1 by b is equal to lambda. Here we equated the j component of this. If we equate the k components, we will get z minus z1 by c is equal to lambda. Therefore, the Cartesian equation, all these three quantities are equal to lambda. Therefore, x minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c is equal to lambda. This is the Cartesian equation of a line passing through a point x1, y1, z1 and parallel to a vector with direction ratios a, b and c. First we study what is the vector equation of a line passing through a point with a position vector vector a and parallel to another vector vector m is vector r is equal to a plus lambda m. That means these two conditions are same, these two equations are same, but one equation is in vector form and the other equation is in Cartesian form. That we can see it on the screen. X minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c is equal to lambda. This is a Cartesian equation of a line. How we can write, how we can change a Cartesian equation of a line into vector form and vector equation of a line to Cartesian form? Let the equation of a line passing through a point with the position vector vector a is 2i plus 3j minus 5k and parallel to a vector is I minus j plus 5k. Then find the equation of the vector passing through this point and parallel to a vector. The given conditions are given. Passing through a point is here and parallel to a vector is given. Then what is the equation of the line? Vector r is equal to vector a plus lambda m. Then a is a passing through the point. Here the point is 2i plus 3j minus 5k is equal to 2i plus 3j minus 5k plus lambda into, instead of m, we can give the vector parallel to, that is I minus j plus 5k. That is vector r is equal to 2i plus 3j minus 5k plus lambda into I minus j plus 5k is the Cartesian vector equation of the line passing through a point and parallel to a vector. How we can convert from the vector equation to Cartesian form? Then we know that the general vector we are denoting by xi plus yj plus zk is equal to the same vector will come. Before I told you, equate the I components. The I component here is x. On the right side it is 2 plus lambda into 1. Therefore, x minus 2 by 1 is equal to lambda. Similarly, if we equate the y component, we will get y minus 3 by minus 1 is equal to lambda, and equate the j component, k component, but we will get z plus 5 by 5 is equal to lambda. Therefore, we got three common quantities. X minus 2 by 1 is equal to lambda, y minus 3 by minus 1 is equal to lambda, and z plus 5 by 5 is equal to lambda. Therefore, the Cartesian equation of a line is x minus 2 by 1 is equal to y minus 3 by minus 1 is equal to z plus 5 by 5. I hope you understood how to find the Cartesian equation to vector and vector to Cartesian form. This is a 1 mark question, can come for the board exam. They will give They will ask the question like that: find the equation of a line passing through a point and parallel to a vector. You can ask for both the forms, Cartesian form and in vector form. If the equation is in Cartesian form, you can first you find it in Cartesian form, or if the equation they are given in form of Cartesian form, convert it into vector, and vector we can convert it into Cartesian form as that. The second one is equation of a line. The second condition is passing through two points. Therefore, here also vector form is there, Cartesian form is there. Here we want to find the equation of the line passing through two points, that is, let the points be vector A and B. Let the points be A and B. Then A is a point with position vector A, and B is a point with position vector B. Or in Cartesian form, instead of A we can write x1, y1, z1, and B we can write x2, y2, z2. Then how we can find the equation of the line passing through a point with position vector A and passing through the point B with the position vector B is, vector R is a general vector. Vector R is equal to A plus lambda into B minus A. Vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda into B minus A. All these are vectors except lambda. Lambda is a scalar quantity. That is, vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda into B minus A is the equation of the line passing through two points with position vectors vector A and vector B. The same, we can convert. How we can convert this Cartesian to vector form is, we know that the point A is equal to x1, y1, z1 and B is equal to x2, y2, z2. Therefore, replace A by x1, y1, z1 and B by x2, y2, z2. Then, xi plus yj plus zk is equal to vector A is equal to x1i plus y1j plus z1k plus lambda into B minus A. In vector analysis or vector algebra, we already studied that how to find the difference of two vectors, that is vector A and vector B. Here instead of A minus B, here B minus A is there, that means vector B minus vector A, that is x2 minus x1 into I plus y2 minus y1 into j plus z2 minus z1 into k. The same way as we did before, first we can equate the I component. The left side the I component is x, and the right side it is x1 plus lambda into x2 minus x1. Therefore, bring x1 to this side, x minus x1, and is equal to lambda into x2 minus x1. Therefore, the value of lambda is x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. If we equate the I component, we got lambda is equal to x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. The same way, if we equate the j component, we will get lambda is equal to y minus y1 by y2 minus y1. And if we equate the k component, we get z minus z1 by z2 minus z1. Here all the values are equal. Therefore, the Cartesian equation of a line passing through two points x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2 is x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 equal y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equal z minus z1 by z2 minus z1. This is equal to lambda. What is the second one we studied? Equation of a line passing through two points with the position vectors vector A and the another point with position vector B is, vector R is equal to vector a plus lambda into b minus a. From this vector equation, or convert this vector equation into Cartesian form, is the a vector is replaced by x1i plus y1j plus z1k, and b vector is replaced by x2i plus y2j plus z2k. Therefore, the Cartesian equation of the line is x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 equal y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equal z minus z1 by z2 minus 1. Just we can recall the things. First we studied what is the relation between direction cosines and the direction ratios of a line. That is, the direction cosines are denoted by L, M, N, or cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma, and the direction ratios are by A, B, C. Therefore, the relation between the direction cosines and the direction ratios is L is equal to A by root of A square plus B square plus C square, M is equal to B by the same denominator, that is A square plus B square plus C square, and N is equal to C by root of A square plus B square plus C square. The second one we studied is equation of a line passing through a point and parallel to a vector. The two conditions are very important. If all the questions are coming to that, it is very difficult to identify the questions. If after this session we will learn, we are going to learn about the planes, then the questions will mix. It is very difficult to identify, so you have to check the conditions what is given in the question. Passing through the point and parallel to a vector. In the vector analysis, you know, instead of parallel, in the direction of, both are same, parallel to, the word parallel to is same as in the direction of. Therefore, equation of a line passing through a point with the position vector, vector A, and parallel to a given vector, vector M, we studied as vector R is equal to A plus lambda M. The Cartesian equation also we studied, x minus x1 by A is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by c is equal to lambda. This is the standard form of the equation passing through the point and parallel to a given vector. The second one is equation of the line passing through a point and passing through two points x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2 is x minus x1 by x2 minus x1 equal y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 equal z minus z1 by z2 minus z1. This is a Cartesian equation, and how, what is a vector form of this one is vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda into B minus A. This we can see it on the screen. An example for the question, how to convert Cartesian to vector form. One Cartesian equation of the line is x minus 5 by 4 is equal to y minus 3 by 5 is equal to z plus 1 by 3. This is a Cartesian equation of a line. How we can convert this Cartesian equation of the line to vector form? One question is coming for the board exam. Convert the Cartesian equation to vector form. Write the Cartesian equation of a line, they will give the vector equation. Or write the vector equation of the line when the Cartesian equation is given. Here the Cartesian equation is given. Then how we can find the vector equation of this line? This is a one mark question. Then here passing through the point, the circled one are the passing through the points. The circled one are the point. We know that the general equation or the normal form we are taking, it is x minus x1 by a is equal to y minus y1 by b is equal to z minus z1 by z minus z1 by c. Okay, compare these two equations. Instead of x1, the number here it is 5. Instead of y1, the number here it is 3. Instead of z1, the number here it is minus 1. You know why it comes? The normal form is z minus z1. Therefore, we can replace this by z minus minus 1. therefore z1 is equal to minus 1. That is, this x1, y1, z1 is a passing through the point. Therefore, the vector A, we can replace it as 5y plus 3j minus 1k. Therefore, the point we got. Then, parallel to the vector, we learned that this A, B, C are the direction ratios of the vector parallel to. Therefore, this in the position of A, here it is A. Therefore, 4. Position of B, it is 5. And C, we can replace by 3. Therefore, the parallel vector, we can write it as vector M is equal to 4i plus 5j plus 3k. The two conditions we got, passing through the point and parallel to the vector we got. Therefore, the Cartesian vector equation is vector r is equal to a plus lambda b. What is the vector r here? 5i plus 3j plus minus k plus lambda into m. 4i plus 5j plus 3k. So, we can convert Cartesian to vector and vector to Cartesian. Is there one more question coming for the exam? The second case we studied, equation of a line passing through two points. They will give equation on the two points and we want to find the equation of the line. Now, you can see one question on the screen. Find the equation of a line in both vector and Cartesian form which passes through the point 5 minus 2, 4 and parallel to the vector 2i minus j plus k. This is the first one related to that. Passes through the point is given that 5, 2 minus 4 and parallel to the vector 2i minus j plus k. Instead of that, how we can replace it? Vector A. Vector A, we can replace it as passes through the point. Passes through which point? 5 minus 2, 4. Therefore, we can replace A as 5i minus 2j plus 4k. And parallel to the vector, we can replace it as vector M is equal to 2i minus j plus k. These two conditions are given. Therefore, vector R is equal to A plus lambda M. If you substitute the values, we will get the vector form. And Cartesian form also, if you substitute, vector R can be replaced by xi plus yj plus zk is equal to 5i minus 2j plus 4k plus lambda into 2i minus j plus k. Therefore, the Cartesian equation is x minus 5 by, what is the coefficient of I here? 2. Then x minus 5 by 2 is equal to y plus 2 by minus 1 is equal to z minus 4 by 1. This is a Cartesian equation of the line passing through the point and parallel to a line. The next one is the passing through the point and passing through two given points. One question, you can see it, seen it on the board screen. Find the vector and Cartesian equation of the line passing through the point 3, 4, minus 7. 3, 4, minus 7 and 5, 1, 6. Here we want to find the equation of the line passing through these two points 3, 4, 7 and 5. You can find in Cartesian form or vector form, that your wish. You can then if you are finding the Cartesian form, you convert it into vector form. If you are finding it in the vector form, convert it into Cartesian form. Okay, first we can write this is a vector with position vector vector A and this is with vector B. Therefore, vector R is equal to vector R is in which form? This now we are going to write in which form? That is a vector form. Vector R is equal to vector A 3i plus 4j minus 7k plus lambda into b minus a. B minus a means the subtraction of the vectors. Difference between the two vectors came here. 5 minus 3, that is 2i. 1 minus 4, 3i. 6 minus minus 7. is 13k. Therefore, vector r is equal to 3i plus 4j minus 7k plus lambda into 2i minus 3j plus 13k. It's the equation of the line passing through these two points. Then here we got in vector form. How we can convert this vector into Cartesian form is this. We know that r can be replaced by xi plus yj plus zk. Then equate the I components. Here it is x. If we take 3 to this side, the positive 3 become minus 3 divided by the coefficients along with lambda, that is 2 lambda. See, 2 is equal to lambda. Therefore, x minus 3 by 2 is equal to lambda. Then the I by j component is y minus 4 by here it is minus 3 lambda. Therefore, minus 3 is equal to lambda. And the k component is on the left side, it is z is equal to here minus 7 z, here minus 7 is here. If you take to this side, it will become z plus 7 divided by lambda and 13 is equal to lambda. Therefore, the Cartesian equation is x minus 3 by 2 is equal to y minus 4 by 3 is equal to z plus 7 by 3. This is a Cartesian equation of the line passing through the points 3, 4 minus 7 and 5, 1, 6. Therefore, for two type of questions we studied, equation of the line passing through a point and parallel to a vector, equation of the line passing through two points. Both the cases we studied how to convert the equation to vector form and Cartesian form. The next one related to the lines in space is how we can find the angle between two lines. Here also vector form is there, Cartesian form is there. First we can study the Cartesian form. Vector r is equal to a plus lambda b. Therefore, if two lines are there, then we can replace a by a1, here b by b1. We are going to find the angle. What is the formula for finding the angle between two lines? Vector r is equal to a1 plus lambda b1, and vector r is equal to a2 plus mu b2. The angle between these two vectors, that is these two lines, vector r is equal to this one and vector r is equal to this one, is let theta be the angle between the lines. It is equal, cos theta is equal to, after lambda, what is the vector here? B1. Then after mu, what is the vector here? It is B2. That is B1 dot B2 divided by mod B1 mod B2 and the modulus. The angle between the two vectors, two are lines, vector r is equal to a1 plus lambda b1, and vector r is equal to a2 plus mu b2, is cos theta equal b1 dot b2 by modulus b1 modulus b2. B1 dot b2, how we can find b1? But then the vector analysis in the chapter vector, you studied how to find the dot product of two vectors, then find the dot product, take the modulus of the vectors and modulus of b1 and modulus of b2. Then just we can recall how to find the dot product of the vectors b1 dot b2. For example, let b1 is equal to I plus j plus k, b2 is equal to 2i minus 5j plus 3k. Then how to find b1 dot b2 equal is equal to, multiply the I component. Here the I component is 1 and here the I component is 2. 2 1s are 2 plus minus 5, and here the I component is, j component is 1, minus 5 plus, multiply these two components, that is 3. That is 2 minus 5 minus 3 plus 3 is equal to, here we got b1 dot b2 is equal to 0. That is how to find b1 cross b2 means, multiply the components of I, j and k. Then the another quantity here, it is modulus b1. Modulus b1, how to find it was, or how to find the modulus of a vector is b1 is equal to I plus j plus k. How to find the modulus of a vector is the components of I, j and k square, sum of the squares of the components of I, j and k. Modulus b is equal to, here the component is 1, here also 1, here also 1. Therefore, 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square is equal to root 3. B1, how to find the dot product of two vectors means multiply the I component, j component and k component, and how to find the modulus of a vector is root of x square plus, actually the formula is x square plus y square plus z square, or square of the sum of the squares of the I, j and k component, that will give the modulus of a vector. Therefore, come to the topics again. Two lines are here. Here we have to find the angle between the two lines. The angle between the two lines is cos theta. Cos theta is equal to b1 dot b2 by mod b1 mod b2. Here the lines are given in vector form. Here the lines are given in vector form. If the lines are given in Cartesian form, what is the formula for finding angle between two lines? The Cartesian form, the equation is x minus x1 by a1 equal y minus y1 by b1 equal z minus z1 by c1, and x minus x2 by a2 is equal to y minus y2 by b2 is equal to z minus z2 by c2. Here two lines are there. The equations are in Cartesian form. Then this a1, b1 and c1 are the direction ratios of the first line. A2, B2 and C2 are the direction ratios of the second line. Then the angle between the line cos theta is equal to, here the direction ratio is A1, here it is A2. A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 by root of A1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. This, if the equation is in Cartesian form, the angle between the lines cos theta is equal to a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 by root of a square plus a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square. And if the equation of the line is in vector form, cos theta is equal to b1 dot b2 by mod b1 mod b2, that we can see it on the screen, the formula and how to find the angle between the two lines. That is, cos theta is equal to modulus a1 a2 plus b1 b2 plus c1 c2 by root of a1 square plus b1 square plus c1 square into root of a2 square plus b2 square plus c2 square, and cos theta is equal to mod b1 dot b2 by mod b1 mod b2. Therefore, you can now, after that we can solve one question, that also we can see it on the screen. Find the angle between the two vectors, two lines. Here the first question is, the lines are given in the form of vectors. That is, vector r is equal to 2i minus 5j plus k plus lambda into 3i plus 2j plus 6k. Here the line is in vector form. The second one is, vector r is equal to 7i minus 6k plus mu into I plus 2j plus 2k. How we can find the equation of the angle between the lines using these two vectors? We know that the equations are in vector form. Therefore, cos theta is equal to, the formula is b1 dot b2 by mod b1 mod b2. And check with this equation, the first equation, vector r is equal to a1 plus lambda b1, and the second one is vector r is equal to a2 plus mu b2. Therefore, from here we will get b1 is equal to 3i plus 2j plus 6k and b2 is equal to I plus 2j plus 2k. B1 is equal to 3i plus 2j plus 36k and b2 is equal to I plus 2j plus 2k. Then cos theta is equal to b1 dot b2 by mod b1 mod b2. First we can find, separate we can find, after that we can substitute the values there. B1 dot b2 is equal to, the first vector is 3i plus 2j plus 6k dot I plus 2j plus 2k. Then how to find the dot product of vectors? This we can recall from the vector analysis is multiply the I component, j component and the k component. Here the I components are 3 into 1 3 plus 2 into 2 4 plus 6 2 is 12. This is 17 we got. Then the numerator we got, and the modulus b1 also we already studied in vector analysis. Modulus b1 is equal to root of the components, sum of the squares of the I components and j components, k components, 3 square plus 2 square plus 6 square, 9 plus 4 plus 36, root 49 is equal to 7. The same way we can find mod b2 also. Mod b2 is equal to, here the vector b1 is I plus 2j plus 2k, therefore mod b2 is equal to square root of 1 plus 4 plus 4 root 9 is equal to 3. If we substitute the values in this equation, cos theta is equal to, instead of b1 dot b2 we can substitute 17. 17 divided by 17 divided by mod b1 is same as 7 into 3, that is 17 by 21. Then cos theta is equal to 17 by 21, therefore theta is equal to cos inverse 17 by 21, that is a, this is a, cos theta is equal to 17 by 21 is the angle between the two lines, 2i minus 5j plus k plus lambda into this one and this lines. Therefore here the equations are given in forms of Cartesian equation. After a small break, we can come back again.